Hey y'all, I'm Amy Grubbs, and this is day 9 of our Advent reading plan, O Come, Let Us Adore Him. Today we're going to look at the amazing story of worship in the life of Apostle Paul. I'm going to read out of Acts 16, verses 16 through 34. So listen, follow along with me if you have your Bible. See what the Lord might be speaking to you, and see what catches your attention. Once, when we were going to the place of prayer, we were met by a slave girl who had a spirit by which she predicted the future. She earned a great deal of money for her owners by fortune-telling. This girl followed Paul and the rest of us, shouting, "These men are servants of the Most High God who are telling you the way to be saved." She kept this up for many days. Finally, Paul became so troubled that he turned around and said to the spirit, "In the name of Jesus Christ, I command you to come out of her." At that moment, the spirit left her. When the owners of the slave girl realized that their hope of making money was gone, they seized Paul and Silas and dragged them into the marketplace to face the authorities. They brought them before the magistrates and said, "These men are Jews, and they are throwing our city into an uproar by advocating customs unlawful for Romans to accept or practice." The crowd joined in the attack against Paul and Silas, and the magistrates ordered them to be stripped and beaten. After they had been severely flogged, they were thrown into prison, and the jailer was commanded to guard them carefully. Upon receiving such orders, he put them in the inner cell and fastened their feet into the stocks. About midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God, and the other prisoners were listening to them. Suddenly, there was such a violent earthquake that the foundations of the prison were shaken. At once, all the prison doors flew open and everybody's chains came loose. The jailer woke up, and when he saw the prison doors open, he drew his sword and was about to kill himself because he thought the prisoners had escaped. But Paul shouted, "Don't harm yourself. We are all here." The jailer called for lights, rushed in, and fell trembling before Paul and Silas. He then brought them out and asked, "Sirs, what must I do to be saved?" They replied, "Believe in the Lord Jesus, and you will be saved, and you and your household." Then they spoke the word of the Lord to him and to all the others in the house. At that hour of night, the jailer took them and washed their wounds. Then immediately he and all his family were baptized. The jailer brought them into this house and set a meal before them. He was filled with joy because he had come to believe in God, he and his whole family. If I were in prison, I'm not sure I'd be singing hymns like Paul and Silas were. And I love that it says that in the Bible, other prisoners were actually listening to them as they were singing. Because they did, chains were broken literally and spiritually that day. So sing, praise God. You never know who your worship might reach.